Hello there. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I am the host, Damon Pettit. And let's see if we can get something to work today, huh? I am going to be doing a beautiful Montecristo Series C Toro. And here is what it looks like. Brown and pretty. Actually looking forward to this. Always look forward to a good cigar, actually. Doesn't have to usually be any certain kind, just a decent cigar. Feels like the draw's gonna be okay. Now, I'm trying one new thing, and that is, I bought a little microphone to hook into my iTouch, see if it helps out. It'll probably ruin everything, we'll see. This is a Toro, and it's a 6x54, so it's got a nice big ring gauge. Kind of like a bigger ring gauge, I guess, for the way it feels. I don't know. Of course, for me, the flavor, depending on all the different blends of tobacco that are in there. How's everybody doing? Right now I'm playing Enigma. I'm going to be pulling it. Finding some music that is okay to play and to have on YouTube. Because depending on what it is I play, it actually, some stuff gets blocked in some other countries, so we don't want that to happen. There's a helicopter. So bad, a little bit creamy. Can you hear me? God. Gonna have a little bit of wine. Have some wine here. I was going to, I was going to actually do this review earlier today, and so I got all my stuff, cameras and all this crap in the car, took a ride down to downtown Phoenix, because I thought, I'm going to find a building I can get on top of and do a review up there. In order to do that, first of all, you have to find a place that's open. I don't know if any of you have been to downtown Phoenix, but wow, it's got a lot of nothing there. A little bit surprised. I'm from Denver, and so, I mean, that's not, you know, that's not a Chicago, it's not, you know, New York, LA, but it's a decent sized city, and it's got some livelihood to it. I'm not a kind of guy that goes out and parties all the time, so, you know, I really hadn't been down there too much, probably just a couple times since I've even lived here, in actual downtown Phoenix. Seems like that's the place you go when you have to go to court, or you gotta go to work. There is a, what is down there? think the Diamondback stadium is there. Yeah, it's where the Diamondbacks play, I'm pretty sure. it's and that, I mean, I really thought that it would be a little bit more lively than it was. It was just dead. I drove and walked around for a little over an hour and just really couldn't find any place that would be suitable and fun and worth, you know, doing the whole thing. So came back home and decided to just hang out, do some website work, and then watched a little bit off and on the Green Bay game. And interesting, they're out. Yeah, it's just how football is. You never know. I did not expect my Broncos to win. I did not expect them to have their asses handed to them on a platter of some sort. But actually, what really happened was New England came in ready to kill anything that got in their way, and they just destroyed them. So very interesting. So now we see we got the AFC and NFC championship all ready to go. It'll be New England and the Ravens. And the Giants at San Francisco. Incredible. I don't think anybody at the beginning of the year said anything about San Francisco going to the Super Bowl. I know I didn't. And people have picked the Patriots quite often, but I think people were looking more at the Jets. Heard people talk about San Diego, Pittsburgh even. So, you know, that's football, and it's almost over. A couple more games, and boom, off season. Let's talk about the cigar a little bit now, huh? Series C Montecristo. On first light up, when I first lit it up, no spice at all. It was just very mild, kind of a buttery type taste, really. Very nice, very flavorful. Now, we're down this far, not that far. Very nutty to me. Quite a nutty flavor, actually. Light cocoa type. Not bad though. Montecristo is known to be a very good cigar. I paid like $8 for this. Montecristos are up there usually a little bit in price, a little bit more than some other cigars, but not bad. I mean, you know, for a cigar that's known for its quality, for a continued consistent quality, it's the price decently, I think. Not bad. Make sure I didn't. Oh, thought maybe I hurt this one, but it looks okay. Very nice, though. So far, I have not had a ton of Monte Cristos. I've had a few here and there. This one, obviously, you see me smoking it. But the ones I have had have been very nice. Very good cigars. Looks to me like so far with this one and the others I've had, and with the reputation that it's, if you can try them, if you look to see one, it looks like I'll give that a try, more than likely you're going to be pretty decently happy with it. So far this little Toro is doing pretty good. I actually went to looked them up, Montecristo Cigars. There was a website at one point, or a domain for them, but right now, at least, it's not working. I don't know if they have a website named something else, but I couldn't find it. So I just had to kind of do, look some things up here and there, and as long as all the information I got was correct, it's made in the Dominican Republic. I knew it wasn't Cuban, but it is made in the Dominican Republic. The filler is Dominican, Nicaraguan, and Peruvian. That's pretty interesting. I seem to be getting some cigars lately that have different fillers and stuff from Peru and other places, so the wrapper is Cameroon wrapper. So that's not bad. It's a natural cigar, not Maduro, as I'm sure you can tell that. It would be about the color of my shirt probably if it was. But out here in Arizona, very beautiful. Next week, this next coming Friday / Saturday, I'm going to be going up someplace, just hanging out at a hotel for a night, just to kind of get away, read a book and stuff, and I'll probably do a review wherever I am, as long as I can find a decent place to do it. And so that'll be kind of fun, see if I can find a decent enough place and see how that works out. But either way, the reviews are going to start coming out a little bit better now, a little bit quicker. I'm still testing some stuff as far as online and different things like that. I want to, still going to be doing a live thing. I actually was on live a little bit. Let me do that real quick. Stop it first. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this and see if I could stream it online through my phone. Right here is the iTouch. Above it is my backup camera in case I cannot get it off of the iTouch. What I wanted to do was see if I could actually I tried it this last time, and what I mean, I'm trying a couple different things here. I can actually go straight to YouTube. Let me try that too. There we go. So now I'm recording on three different things, and let's see my face there. It'll be interesting how that comes out. People may not see this one because it's just going to be rather odd, but I gotta try, Can't find a place to set it, so we're going to set it someplace weird. And I'm not going to, it's probably not even going to show my face, but that's right. Hello? Let's go a little bit this way. Hello? Come on. Not be mean. Shut the music off. You're just gonna hear my voice. You're getting very sleepy. Just kidding. Don't want you to fall asleep. It's not bad. Not bad at all. It's smoking pretty decently. The hash is pretty nice. It's pretty, pretty thick on there, so it's not just gonna flake and fall off, it looks like, so that's good. I had a few questions that I was asked, and I knocked off pretty nicely, so there's no big funnel in the middle of this thing, that's nice. I kind of see my price point when I buy it, and where they were, their prices were quite a bit different, and that's just mainly like cost of living type of crap, like kind of like in New York, you can get a one bedroom, half a toilet apartment there for $1,200 a month. Out here in Arizona, you'd get a one bedroom, half toilet, or two bedroom, two bathroom, full bathroom for like $800 a month. So, you know, everything varies quite a bit. Prices rise in different places, and then of course the taxes. Everybody loves those. Everybody's state is gonna have different, taxes. So there we go. I'm just testing this. Okay, I just wanted to just having me, didn't know if it was going to have me upload it or not. I'll have to look at that differently. I always try to figure out exactly what I can do to make the process funner, easier, and a lot better as far as the way it looks. Just getting good equipment is really going to help me, I think. So I'll be doing that. Until then, you'll be seeing me with something, I guess, huh? I don't know how many people out there that watch this actually. This thing is like moving, isn't it? Really don't like that. Stop it! Stop it! There we go. Okay. I don't know how many people are online and have like different content, like either through YouTube or Vimeo or Tumblr or Facebook or Twitter. If you are and you like those kind of things, there's another site out there that I just learned about through somebody on Twitter, actually. And she actually had a link to it. I can't remember, but I went to it and I really liked the site. It's called About Me. AboutMe.com, I believe, and it's just one page, and you can have your YouTube link, your website, everything. Just have like a nice picture of you. You have a little bio, and it's like a business card almost on the internet, and it's actually pretty cool. It's fun to go to for me. I actually go and just click and let it pick different people randomly, and I look at their stuff, and it's actually pretty cool. So I'm on there now, and I have both just me as a private individual and my website there, and then my Cigar Review TV one as well. So if you're on aboutme.com, let me know. I will find you and look you up and look at your stuff. And if you're interested in look at mine, just look up Cigar Review TV, or you could also look up Damon Pettit. So either one of those two, I have a page for both. And they're similar. One's all cigar stuff. The other one is just me shit. So enjoy. This cigar has no spice at all. very mild cigar. I didn't expect it to be spicy. I don't know if I expected really what I expected with it, but it's pleasing. It's nice. It's a gentle cigar. If you like a real robust cigar and that's all you smoke and you don't like anything else, you won't like this at all. That is a guarantee. If you like any kind of cigars or whatever, you would like this. I like it. It's got beautiful aroma going on in my face here. I like that. Always like a cigar that's got that aroma, you know, just a nice cigar aroma, just beautiful. I like that. The draw is nice. Not bad at all. It's kind of burning a little bit thick there, but still not bad. I have to really look that up to make sure that that is, because that's something that I was actually taught, that a thick burn line right here, a thick black burn line, means that the tobacco may not have been aged as well or whatever. It was long. I'm going to look to make sure that is true before I keep saying it more and more. I've been saying it for a long time, just mainly because that's what somebody taught me, but who knows, maybe somebody taught them and they were full of shit. So we'll find out. I'll make sure, see if I can find out for sure. It's, you know, I'll have to actually, I'm going to find a cigar guy, somebody who actually makes these, and ask the question. So maybe I'll go to one of the big ones out there that are really out there with the, you know, Facebook and Twitter and stuff. That way you can kind of contact them a little easier. And if I get an answer from somebody, I'll let you know who it is and what the dealio is. I'm not a huge, what do you want to call it, I don't just spend all my time in sports and stuff, but when football's on, I end up kind of watching it a little bit more. So it takes up a little bit more of my time. So I'm kind of glad that season's almost over. It'd be kind of nice. It frees up a little bit of that and do a lot more, a lot of other things. Someday I'll probably just won't ever watch it, but right now, still enjoy it. It's very thrilling sometimes. Sometimes it's not, but a lot of times it is. Hope you're doing very well. Hope you're enjoying your cigars. I hope you're enjoying your coffees, your wines. Get on Twitter. Say hi to me.